Good morning, everyone. I'm Mandeep Singh.
And I'm Ashwin Bijwar.
And we are from the River Godavari. Today, we stand here in front of you to give our induction presentation on the topic
Failure of Maruti Suzuki Kizashi car in India.
Why we chose this topic? So when Kizashi car was launched in India in 2011, we were both really intrigued by the car. And I actually had a poster of the car. And we were very surprised when we saw that Kizashi failed. So we really wanted to know the reasons why Kizashi failed in India. Objectives. We want to show different aspects why Kizashi failed in India.
These are the contents. First, we go through the introduction part. Then the product, details of Kizashi, reason for the failures, problems, competitors, facts and figures, market share in unit, market size in 2018, and finally the conclusion.
Introduction. Maruti Suzuki was formerly known as Maruti Suzuki Udyog Limited. It's a joint venture between Maruti and Suzuki Motor Corporation of Japan. Suzuki Motor Corporation actually owns 56.21% of Maruti Suzuki. It's headquartered in New Delhi and it was founded in 1981. Its chairman is Mr. Asi Bhargava and CEO and MD is Mr. Kenichi Ayugawa.
These are the products of Maruti. Automobiles comes with the three classes. First one is the economy class, second one is the standard class, and third one is the premium class. But in Maruti, they have only two classes. They didn't exist in a premium class. So they have only two classes, economy and the standard. Economy and the standards. Economy class ranges below the 10 lakhs rupees, and they include the hatchbacks and minivans. And on the other hand, standard class ranges below the 14 lakh rupees, and they include minivans, sedans, and mini MPVs.
So I want to ask you a question.
Yeah.
Does anybody knows for which purpose this car is mostly used? That's right. It's used for kidnapping. It's very famous among the gangsters.
Apart from the ambulance.
SBS uses it as an ambulance.
Yeah. This is.
Let's see a short video.
It's okay.
Remember when sleek, finely crafted performance sedans were just for rich guys with money to burn? Well, those days are officially over. Presenting Kizashi from Suzuki, class-leading standard horsepower and available all-wheel drive at a price everyone can appreciate.
Guys, how was the video? Do you like or not? Coming with the details of Kizashi. Kizashi car was launched on 2nd February 2011 in India, and the engine type is having the 2.4 liters petrol engine, which is capable of producing 185 horsepower with the displacement of 2400cc, and they have the push button start also, and available in AWD, FWD modes, and also available in manual and CVT transmission. Does anyone know what is CVT transmission here? Yeah, that's right.
Yes, you know, Ashwin. Continuous variable
transmission.
Yeah,
that's right.
That's right. And it comes with the price line of 16 to 17.5 lakhs in Indian rupees.
Now coming to the main slide. Why did Kizashi fail in the Indian market? Kizashi was sold as a CBU unit in the Indian market. CBU stands for completely built up unit. There's another unit called CKD unit, which stands for completely knockdown unit. Completely built up unit means that the car was fully imported in the Indian market. Not a single part of the car was made in India or was assembled in India.
Coming with the second point, pricing was not suitable for the Indian market. As my friend Mandeep just told you, it was a completely built up unit car, which is imported directly from Japan. So it's in Indian market, the customer who wanted to buy the car, they were getting the car at ₹16 to 17.5 lakh. On the other hand, Americans who wanted to buy this car for the same price and with the same features, they would getting the same car with the 12 lakh approximately. That was the huge difference that time.
So when you import something from somewhere, you have to pay the tax. So when Kizashi was imported to India, it has to come through heavy taxes. Indian government has put on almost a tax of 105%. So which increased the price of Kizashi up to 16 to 17.5 lakhs. Despite CEPA, which stands for Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement, which was signed between Japanese and Indian government in the same month in which Kizashi was launched in India, that is February 2011. But that agreement did not include cars. In that agreement, both the countries decided that they will reduce their trade tariffs. India decided to reduce its trade tariff by almost 90% on Japanese exports, and Japan decided to reduce its trade tariffs by almost 90%. But that agreement did not include cars. It only included video games and small stuff, but not cars. So Kizashi has to come through India by paying huge taxes.
Coming to the fourth point, Maruti brand image. Traditionally, Maruti being a small car segment specialist, as we all know, and they, in 2011, they directly introduced their first ever sedan, luxury sedan. So they basically directly jump from a small car segment into a sedan segment. So that's one of the reasons to fail in India, the Kizashi car.
So problems of Kizashi. Kizashi is basically a really good car, but it has a couple of glitches, only two. The glove box door. Does anybody knows what glove box door is in a car? Anybody? Yes. What? Yeah.
Yes.
Right.
That's right.
It's actually the door in the glove compartment in which we keep all the documents and papers. It's made for miscellaneous storage. So in case of a crash, Kizashi has a tendency to get the glove box door open, which could harm the passenger sitting in the front seat. And the evaporating canister has a tendency to get blocked. Evaporating canister is the canister when fuel comes to the engine from the fuel tank, it comes through the evaporative canister. And when the evaporative canister has a tendency to get blocked, it creates a huge amount of tremendous pressure inside the fuel tank, which could cause the fuel tank to crack and which could cause fire later on.
These are the competitors of Kizashi. Kizashi has the two main competitors. One, first one is the Honda Civic, and second one was the Toyota Corolla LTs. They both comes with the price line of 12 to 14 lakhs, whereas the Kizashi price was so high. And the mileage of Honda Civic and Corolla LTs are getting the 15.5 kmpl, whereas the Kizashi car was that time for providing only 12.5 kmpl mileage. It's not a fuel efficient car, but the Maruti is mainly known as a fuel efficient car providers, and the Honda Civic and the Corolla LTs, they were in a market for that time almost 3 years, and the Maruti Suzuki Kizashi for that only 2 years sustained that market that time.
Coming to the facts and figures of Maruti Suzuki in India. So these are the facts and figures of Maruti Suzuki when Kizashi was launched in India, that is 2011 and 10 and 12. In 2011, the net sales of Kizashi was 35,849 crore. And in 2011 and 12, it fell down to 34,705 crores, which is almost a downfall of 3.2%. And the net profit of Kizashi, Maruti Suzuki in 2010-11 was 2,288 crores, which fell down to 1,635 crores in 2011-12, which is almost a downfall of 28.6%. And market share of Kizashi in 2010-11 was 37.6%. And in 2011 and 12, it was 38.3%. Kizashi's market share in 2011-12 was 2.5%.
Market share in units. Maruti Suzuki was being in the first rank also, always. And they sold 17,252 units. And in 2018, 17,31,450 units, which helps them to grow 8.05%. And market size and market share in 2018. Total market size of Indian automobiles for the year 2018 was 1,58,606 crores Indian rupees. And Maruti, among them, Maruti's share was 78,104 crores Indian rupees. Here is a pie chart which shows the 50%